Tonight's Good News Weekend is rated M for mature audiences and contains material which may offend.
Dad, are you dead?
What?
I was down the stock exchange buying stuff and someone said you were dead, and then I couldn't buy as much stuff.
Do I look like the dead boy? Do I bloody look like the bloody dead? Do I bloody do it? That's who I want.
No, Dad, I've never seen the dead.
You saw Ray Martin when he threatened to go to Seven, didn't you? Yeah. There are two things you need to know about the dead boy. They can't move and they can't talk.
What about zombies, Dad? Zombies can move and they're dead. Maybe you're a zombie walking the earth and buying stuff.
I'm talking, boy. Zombies can't bloody talk. They're only a zombie if they're moving and not talking.
What does it mean if they can talk but can't move?
They've signed a contract with Channel 9.
I love this country, and I want this country to be great, but it isn't. It's a slow country. It's a weak country. We've been losers for too long, and it's time to do something about it. We can be winners, people. We can be better, stronger, faster, and there's a very simple way to achieve it. Drugs. As we curse the rest of the world for their heinous, criminal, unsportsmanlike behaviour in taking performance-enhancing drugs, I want to see all our athletes weighing big, meaty chunks of testosterone into a cup. Samantha Riley. Who cares if she's popped 57 Codral washed down with a bottle of Benadryl expectorant, if it means gold, gold, gold for Australia? And Scotty Miller. Does his enjoyment of the occasional jazz cigarette matter if he gets halfway down the pool before the race actually starts? More power to him. Eckhart Arbeit. So he manufactured East German female swimmers with scrotums the size of house bricks. Well, so what if they were 1, 2, 3 on the podium? We should be embracing this wonderful opportunity, but no, no. They even want to test the Australian cricket team. Well, get over it. From what we know of their habits, Shane Warne's drug of choice is a Mars bar pizza. And just this week, Newcastle Rugby League stars Robbie O'Davis and Wayne Richards were suspended for 22 weeks for taking steroids. 22 weeks! This ban is wrong. It's unfair to give a player more weeks suspension than he can count up to. Nah, 20 would have been all right, you know, if he took his shoes and socks off. But 22 is just plain cruel. O'Davis says he didn't consider himself a drugs cheat. It was a complete surprise when he woke up one morning and found the steroid fairy had turned him into a great hulking monster. With the loss of two key players, Newcastle will need to speed up their back line. I hear Dean Capobianco is free. The steroid abuse has been an integral part of sport forever. We've always had athletes who are built like brick shithouses without the building approval. And I mean, it's so hard to know what's safe and what isn't these days when there's even a banned substance in some breakfast cereals. And really, how are athletes expected to know there's something dodgy in deliciously enhancing steroid pops now with new non-testicle shrinking formula? How would they know that?
Well, there's no... I couldn't agree with you more, mate.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mikey Robbins!
I reckon we've gotten really namby-pamby about drugs. Like, when I was playing under-8s, like, under-8s, front row forward, for the game, there they'd be, shoveling the steroids in. Just to just help us bulk up a bit.
Well, it certainly helped you, Aston. When's it going to stop working?
I mean, come on, mate, I'm an athlete. I was a sportsman.
He's a sportsman. Look at that, he's a sportsman, ladies and gentlemen, yeah.
No, I think what we've got in this country, we've got the year 2000 coming up, we've got two great things in this country. Great scientists and great athletes.
CSIRO.
Let's bring the two together. You know, if we want to go for gold, the only problem is rigorous drug tests. So what I'm calling on is for every patriotic Australian to do their duty.
Exactly.
You know what you mean? We're going to need something very special from all of you.
For our athletes. Oh, what's your body like, mate?
My body's a temple.
Dark and seldom visited.
Thank you, Paul, thank you. What about you?
I'm clean and I'm full.
Well, shall we do the right thing by Australia?
Let's go for gold.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we want red-blooded, sports-loving Australians everywhere to drink your bathwater, suck your garden hoses dry, and then using your body as your tool. Fill up empty Vegemite jars with clean specimens and mail them directly to that inspirational sports administrator, Arthur Tunstall. Come the year 2000 Olympics, we'll piss it in.
Light. Me and my friends were trying hard to get it right. We were making something out of nothing. With all our mind and all our heart, you don't really have a heart. You just wanna come round here. You just wanna come round here. Take things over. Call yourself a businessman. Parasite, 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 parasite. You're the kind who'd sell your mother. Always looking around for something you can't believe in. You can't fail, you got faith for sale. And there's money in stealing other people's dreams. You don't really have a dream of your own. You just want to come round here. You just want to shake my hand. Make me over. Telling me that you really understand. Parasite. 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 Parasite.
Thank you. I like to demonstrate one of my attention-seeking devices for you now, called the pterodactyl. The pterodactyl is perfect for when you meet someone for the first time or in a job interview situation, which I'd like to demonstrate for you now. I'll play the part of the manager and myself because I'm good at playing characters. Hello? Mr. Sandman? That's the manager. Yes? That's me. So, you're here about the metallurgist position, are you? Yes. Oh, let's just check your credentials then. Oh, I see you failed the HSC 4 times. Straight away, he's forgotten about those 4 HSC results. The end.
Thank you, good evening. Tonight, for your consideration, a man with a dark past, Mikey Robbins. Oh. Actor, singer, husky voice, temptress, Zoe Carides.
Oh, yeah.
And clean-living, baby-faced, Anthony Morgan. Oh. Oh. And their sworn enemy is the woman with an outfit for every occasion, Julie McCrossan. There's that outfit. Singer, author, Wild Witch of the West, Fiona Horn. And a man who really knows how to make an exit, Peter Burner. Oh, all very nice memories there, ladies and gentlemen. Very nice. I'm just glad I managed to escape that.
Mind you, it was funny working on Swiggles the first time I was ever romantically linked with another star of a show.
Steam Shovel.
Yeah.
Mikey and Bill Steam Shovel having a lovely time.
He was a dancer.
Okay, let's start.
It was always my favourite.
Yeah.
What? Hurry up.
Yeah, and that's really bad to hear in the bedroom, too.
I don't mind.
Well, let's start the show. Mikey, Zoe, Anthony, this is The Modern World.
Satan.
Adriana.
I'm sure I'm related to her somehow. I'm not really. She's Greek.
Well, Xenides does mean person who can spin letter.
I think Adriana she's the royalty. She's the regal family of people who are just hanging around with guys who are on quiz shows.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the sentence. Come on.
Mind you, though,
can I go home now?
No, we got a full hour of fun.
Mind you, though, have you caught catchphrase, the quiz show for people too dumb to go on Wheel of Fortune? It's actually a British story. There was a game show in Britain that was giving away spam as
no.
Like... Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, Wheel of Spam.
As a big prize.
Well, as a booby prize.
As a booby!
As a booby... Whoa.
I won't bloody have
spam
relegated to the booby prize.
You love spam, you love it.
Spam is the backbone of this nation.
Actually, that's what it's made of, the backbone of the pig. That was the...
What about the three guys?
Well, that was Teenage Fan Club, right? And a lot of them were people like Anthony, people who were... they're known as the fans of Spam. Okay. And they've started picketing the show, demanding that Spam be treated more respectfully.
Exactly, because this country rides on Spam's back!
But isn't it a British product?
Exactly!
Good point, Julie.
Don't
know what to say
about
that.
Isn't. Anyway. It's made here from our own pig's nipples and toenails.
You can make 3/4-pounder burgers if you only carve it like that.
No, that's a spam burger, spam burger, spam burger, spam burger.
Oh, that's what I meant.
I'm going to give you 4 points.
Okay.
In Britain, lovers of that real spiced ham delicacy, Spam, have formed the Spam Fan Club.
God.
Spam lovers decided to start the club after a TV game show began handing out tins of Spam as booby prizes. But it's not the first time game show contestants have gone home with second-rate meat. Who could forget Perfect Match? Thank you! Thank you! We will sink to the depths! When you join the Spam Club, you get a CD by Wham with the W and H crossed out, an SP written on top of it. A recipe book, 101 things to do with Spam, 102 if you're prepared to eat it. And a range of spiced ham-based cleaning products called Spamwave. There's also a Spam website featuring Spam art, like, you know, paintings and sculpture. But imagine the Spam chat room. What color is your Spam? Pink. Mine's pink too.
Every Julie. Meeting of the Spam Club is open with a small key attached to the bottom.
Clink. Ah.
That just shows how far you are away from the modern Spam.
Oh, is that gone? Is it?
Is it working?
Well, that's what's wrong with this world, Morgan.
Yes. Well, too many people in the Spam with this
world. Anthony, how do you get into a tin of Spam in the late 90s?
You take it out for a drink.
How do I get in?
Yeah. I get in with my teeth and nails. Because I love it.
There, you heard it there, ladies and gentlemen. If you want your children to grow up like Anthony Morgan, feed them Spam. Julie. Tony, Fiona, Peter, some news from the modern world for you.
What is it?
That's Elvis Costello, Every Day I Write the Book.
Every Day I Write the Book.
Charter.
Chapter.
Chapter.
Oh, chapter of a book. Okay.
Yeah,
still
in the real quick.
African Arctic waste.
A lot of mail.
That's all the mail. Oh, John Howard. Boom! Oh! John Howard, go bye-bye.
What is the story?
Well, it's all about the mail that turns up at my place. It's addressed to the people that used to live there.
No, it's not.
I was
maybe
just
that's a personal gripe.
Personal grievance
this
there.
This is a sort of a law and order story. As so many states of our country go to election time, they often turn to law and order. And that, I think this is about a man in America who's got the never-ending sentence, a guy who's never, ever going to get out, the Unibomber.
Theodore Kaczynski. Is never going to get out of prison, but in that truly American fashion, he's going to sell his life story for millions of dollars. So little kiddies all around America are going to think, well, let's mail something explosive to someone and I can be famous too.
Well, he's
and I think, good on you!
Well, he's trying to push for it, but even in the land of self-promotion, there's a little bit of nervousness about a man who's killed so many people making a buck, but he's endeavouring to write his book.
He's endeavouring to write a book
the
about his
The Spam man's got something to say.
Yes, Spam.
I'm confused by if you sell your book while you're in prison and you get millions of dollars.
Yes.
What are you going to buy?
Another
Spam!
A sell by yourself if you're smart. Chances are the book will go out mail order and he won't sell any.
5 points! Why do they get one more point?
Yeah.
Because I like them more at the moment. But I could, you know, I could change over the course of the night. I could, you know, like you people more.
All right. Don't ask.
It's a mood thing. It's a mood thing with
me. It's arbitrary power.
It's a pathetic power game.
Yeah, I'm just learning. You know, this is really, okay.
Let's get on with the game.
In America, the Unabomber Ted Kaczynski is trying to interest publishers in a book about his case. Unfortunately, Ted hasn't had any takers yet, possibly because he's been sending his proposal in the mail. The alleged bomber says the book will be hard to put down, particularly for those who picked up one of his earlier works. It contains a wealth of previously unknown Unabomber detail. The unsuccessful early years experimenting with faxing bombs. The unsuccessful later years when he tried email. But don't you think it's weird that the Unabomber is still allowed to post letters? I mean, if they really want to punish him, they should put him somewhere where he doesn't have access to mail services. Like rural Australia. And at the moment, we're looking at 4 for Mikey's team and 5 for the other team. It's weird, it's crazy, but it's going on now.
I am sick and tired of these sensitive new age men.
So much so that I have formed my own anti-men's group, called Mongrel. Men offended by new age goody-goody ratbag effeminate losers. Giddy out of it, you mongrel. Giddy out, you mongrel. Giddy out. God, they make me so angry, those people. I can hardly get a word out. Bitumen. Damn, wrong word.
Start round two, come on, feel the noise. Zoe and Anthony will imitate the introductions to three well-known songs using only sounds.
Oh dear.
2 points.
Don't laugh yet, Peter Burner.
Yes, don't laugh yet because the big laughs are coming very shortly. 2 points for every song. Mikey can make through out the noise. Here we go.
Okay.
Can we know what the songs are?
There's your song.
He's showing us love.
Can I have a look?
Making sense?
Okay.
Ready?
I suggest we start this one.
Oh!
Man, put it down.
Can you do the beginning?
Yeah, no, let's not, let's not fight.
Okay. Ready, set. Oh!
Da dun, 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 da dun.
Oh, yeah, I'm glad I'm just enjoying it. It's a Sherbet, how's that?
Yes! Got it, ladies and gentlemen, 2 points.
I don't ever remember Daryl doing that.
He had too much spray in his head.
Next song.
Okay. Okay, that's good.
Who's the Anthony?
No, that's not the bass line. That's
no, no, that's the drum beat.
Yeah, that's the drum beat.
And I'll do...
My team is falling apart. This is good.
There is a bass line. That's what I was doing
before. Energy now, energy now.
This is just like a cabinet meeting.
Fantastic teamwork, ladies and gentlemen.
Tell me.
It's Madonna, Material
Thank
Girl.
Thank you very much.
Like some bizarre lap dancing place.
You're not exactly like working with a musical master here, are you?
Is it a stroke? Drink! Have a drink! Don't!
Is that the intro?
I have no idea.
No!
Frankie goes to Hollywood, relax!
Yes!
But I can't.
Relax, don't do it!
We mind it!
I'm in 94 points! Oh, no way! Songs were How's That, Sherbet, Madonna's Material Girl, and Relax, Frankie Goes to Hollywood.
Relax has got one bass note throughout the entire song,
and
then there's some sort of tootling.
And that's not in the beginning, Paul.
Infernal tootling,
I might add. I'm sorry we gave you such a hard one, but the lion back there groaning to yourself doesn't exactly give me anything to go on.
It's mime.
Relax, don't do it when you want to come.
And moving on now, ancient Hollywood legend Zsa Zsa Gabor is coming to Melbourne to promote her latest career move, a dance song called Relax. And no, thank God, it's not the one they just did. And I'm sorry, but Zsa Zsa sounds like a giant panda name to me. Although I hear she's made it in captivity a lot more often. Sadly, as often happens with dance tracks, the video for the song will feature someone younger and better looking miming the vocal, Margaret Scott. Zsa Zsa, of course, keeps her real age a closely guarded secret, but it's easy enough to work it out. You just count the rows of stitching
behind her ears and multiply by 10. Okay, brave enough to feel the noise, Mr. Burnett?
I believe so.
Okay.
Oh, here we go.
We're ready, Julie? Sir. Let's see what you've got. Try and do a bit better than that heap of...
Personified.
Sex, raw male sexuality.
Bruce Springsteen, born in the USA. Oh!
Okay,
Dudley do right to the melodies. Oh, yeah, my sex.
I don't have any musical talent. There's no worry about it.
I challenge anybody to listen to those six songs and pick the three with some sort of melody.
The songs were, as we found out, Baby Please Don't Go, Them, Bruce Springsteen, Born in the USA, and Computer Games, My Sex.
Thank you very much.
Brilliant.
We are the winners.
The music industry is panicking at the moment because kids, teenagers and 20-somethings have stopped buying CDs in favour of TV and computer games. So the industry is fighting back by putting the soundtracks from your favourite games on CD. Happily, the old folks haven't been forgotten either, with Smokey Dawson composing a soundtrack for the new seniors computer game, Incontinence Racer.
You have to get Grandpa through the corridors, through the toilet, just in time.
While there is a market for popular music on computer games, surely there's also a market for a game where you hunt down and kill Michael Bolton. And the scores at this point in the game, Mikey Robbins and a musical team are sitting on 8 big points. The Macrossans, with their musical superiority, are sitting on 11 big fat points!
Hello. You can tell a lot about a person from the style of car they drive. I drive a blue Gemini SL with blonde corduroy upholstery. The Gemini is the perfect vehicle for an insignificant person. Every time you go to overtake something, you realise you haven't got enough power. And you go back to where you started. The end.
Idiot Box is the name of the game. 3 TV themes arranged by our very own Gadflies. 2 points for each correct show.
Yeah.
Okay, Zoe.
Yeah, Paul.
Are you ready?
You bet.
Go, Zoe, go. This should be good.
Pretty easy ones, I imagine.
Take it away, boys.
That's relaxed. Frankie goes to Hollywood.
Young one.
In Seattle, and the hills are green and green in Seattle.
It's the only one I know.
In Seattle.
Okay.
Okay, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Do you have those three TV themes?
Yes. I've got the last one.
Oh, good.
Okay, we've got the first two. The Young Ones?
Yep.
What did we say?
Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Mary Tyler Moore Show, yes.
And Morgs?
Here Come the Brides.
They're right, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah! 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 I will give you a couple of extra points if you can sing the words for the Mary Tyler Moore Show.
Love is... She's gonna make it after all.
Okay, you're just four of the words, then we'll be fine.
All right, that'll
love
do.
Love is all around, no need to take it. You can never tell why, don't you make it. You're gonna make it after all.
The hottest program on Moscow television at the moment is a game show called Interception. Contestants try to escape pursuing police in a stolen vehicle. If you can evade the cops for 35 minutes, you get to win the car. And it's harder than it sounds. There aren't many Russian cars that last for 35 minutes. If you do win, you can take the car and leave the show or come back the next night. You get a ski mask, machine gun, an armoured car timetable, and you can go for the big cash jackpot. Losing contestants either get a crappy board game and a beetroot memento of the show, or pulled from wreckage wrapped around a telegraph pole. Julie, all set to take on Idiot Box.
With my tremendous support team, Paul McDermott, yes.
Okay, off you go, lads.
Easy.
Don't
tell
me.
Got it.
We've got it.
Oh,
nothing.
Not the other side. Take it easy, one.
Shut up.
I need another person.
Settle down. Stop fighting.
All right, we're fine. Fiona will take care of this.
Paul, number one.
Paul! Oh, we love this illusion!
Welcome back, Paul! Thank you. Welcome back, Corder. I can't give you any points for that delusion.
I'm sorry, I'm 43 years old. What is this program?
I'm blind.
Julia was on 20 years ago.
It's only the highest rating show that was on during your prime television watching
years. And it's not taking on the ABC?
No.
Well, I'm punished for watching my own station.
Oh, right, well, what do you want them to do? Play the theme to Bellberg three times?
Okay, can we not fight, please, at this point in the show?
Pick on me.
Adam's family.
That's because I'm winning the musical bet.
All right, so you did okay then. Thank you very much. You settled back now for a second. Let's just move on.
The Adams family, and we're prepared to put light bulbs in our ears and make them go on for extra points.
I'll go one better.
The two. Now, last one.
That's funny.
Thank you very much. 4 points at the end of that round for the McCrossan team. And of course, they were Welcome Back, Cotter, which everyone in the audience knew. The Adams family.
Thank you for telling us.
Yes, thank you.
By
the way, you're not in the show. And of course, the Bugs Bunny Show. Another great moment in Australian advertising this week when the Catholic Church branded a new Sizzler TV commercial, Blasphemous. Let's have a look at it.
G'day. What's going on?
There's a fella who's turning two fish and five loaves into thousands.
An illusionist.
How about some prawns and scallops? Or a big juicy steak with a Greek salad? And make that a Caesar salad and lobster pasta. And do that water into wine thing.
Who is you think he is? Sizzler?
You'll please the whole crowd at Sizzler.
I just can't wait till the church sees the rest of the Sizzler campaign. In one ad, the manger is full, so baby Jesus is born in the salad bar. And instead of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, the three wise men bring a plate, tongs, and a selection of condiments. There's another commercial for the all-you-can-eat buffet, in which Christ cures some ham.
Spam!
Thank you for being there for me. There's also one, I think, the Burger King of Kings. And thank you. And in the last of the series, the Son of God actually gives Sizzler a plug from the cross. And in a subtle advertising ploy, the two thieves on either side of him are Colonel Sanders and Ronald McDonald. Beautiful.
The Last Supper.
Oh, you'd want to get the Last Supper.
Take this garlic prawn and eat of it. It is the garlic prawn of the everlasting covenant.
Excuse me, Jesus, I didn't have an entree.
Okay, at the moment, we're sitting pretty with both teams on a nice 15 points. So, very nice. Very happy.
That must be grating on you to know that we did well with the band.
Yeah, you did great with the band. Fantastic.
Just with live music, because we all know that the band's in here because you'd like to sing a song with them. And how obvious is it? This show is just exactly the same as the other bloody show, except it's got a band on it so you can sing one of your putrid songs. I think the public would like, just for a change, to see someone else sing a song with the band, just in case. Paul, I'm not saying anything against your singing, but what if you were to meet with a horrible accident?
Well, that's not likely to happen, but all the same, anyone wants to sing with the band. I mean, Fiona's got a beautiful... You could sing with the band.
Fiona's a singer. Yeah. I mean, how Jolly obvious
could
is sing. That?
Well, what do you want? Mikey could get up and do a number.
Exactly.
I mean, Zoe or Peter could do a song.
Exactly, yeah. But they've all got jobs.
Do you know any songs?
Some guy with no job.
And lots of tests.
Anthony, do you want to sing a song?
Okay.
What are we going to sing there, Mr. Morgan?
Anthony,
you boys like hillbilly music?
Nope.
That's a bit of bad luck. You got a harmonica? What key is that in?
C.
Okay, we're playing in C. That's this sort of shape, isn't it?
Whatever you want.
Okay, good.
Show it up in here.
I met a little girl in Knoxville town. We all know well. And every Sunday evening, out in her home I dwell. We went to take an evening walk about a mile from town. Picked a stick up off the ground and knocked that fair girl down. She fell down on her bended knees. For mercy she did cry. Oh, really dear, don't kill me here. I'm unprepared to die. She never spoke another word. I only beat her more until the ground around me within her blood did flow.
Everybody!
I grabbed her by her golden curls and I drug her and around, throwing her into the river that flows through Knoxville town. Go down, you Knoxville girl, with dark and rolling tide. Go down, you Knoxville girl. Can never be my ride. Go crazy, man.
I'm here to waste my life away down in this dirty old cell, because I buried that Knoxville girl, the girl I love so
Jocular, happy, happy Clem. Roars of laughter at the barber, in the Kmart, at the dentist. Happy, happy Clem. Life of the party, MC for all occasions. Happy, happy Clem. Look, kiddies, it's Clem. Happy, happy Clem. This is the story of happy Clem. Large heart, hearty laugh, likes a flutter, happy Clem. In a swimsuit, varicose vanity, hairy back, happy Clem. Big bum, bum leg, breathless asthmatic, happy Clem. Pock-ridden thyroid trouble, gout inflamed, happy Clem. Unmarried, tiny dick, fat ankled, happy Clem. Lone living, one room flat, rat infested, happy Clem. Illiterate, unachieved, unremarkable, pencil chewing, happy Clem. Stiff, bloated, 2 day old, choked on a cream bun, happy, happy Clem.
Kiss the second round. Good riddance. Broken English. One line of dialogue from a movie. Players must identify the films and who said it. Fiona, for you. You ready?
Yep.
Rosebud.
Oh.
Citizen Kane. Orson Welles.
I don't think we've ever played one game properly.
Why
and
should
for
we?
Those of you who stayed asleep and missed the end, it's a sled. A lot of people fall asleep in movies.
Oh, and Rosebud was actually the name that William Randolph Hearst used for his lover, Mary.
Anyway, we could talk about that all night, I'm sure. My life is better than an ABBA song.
I hope so.
Oh, it's gotta be.
Come on. Yes, sorry, and who said it?
Muriel.
Tony Collette.
Tony Collette, yeah.
We were throwing our voices into those lovely girls.
I'm not going to touch it. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he didn't exist. Just give it to me.
Kevin Spacey.
In that movie.
In the Usual Suspect.
Who's your boyfriend now? Nancy. Who's your boyfriend now, Nancy?
Oh, it's another one.
Here's the clue.
Freddy Krueger. Why am I helping?
Come on.
Freddy Krueger.
Yes, what's the film he was in?
Nightmare.
Thank you very much. Stupid. Okay, here we go.
I'll make it up later.
You will travel far, my little Kal-El. But we will never leave you.
Superman.
Yes, Marlon Brando.
Thank you very much. I'm going to give you at the end of that round
100 points.
I'm going to give you 6 points.
6 points, yeah.
Thank you very much. Okay. Jewish groups in America have attacked the latest Superman comic in which the Man of Steel fights the Nazis in World War II. The groups are angry because nowhere in the story is the word Jew actually mentioned. He's still fighting for truth, justice, and the American way, though. He even helps the entire population of a concentration camp escape. Superman gives each prisoner a pair of Clark Kent glasses, and they walk straight past the guards without being recognized. Unfortunately, the Germans are also complaining that the comic makes them out to be stupid. Like, to infiltrate the SS, Superman just paints an extra S. On the front of his costume. And we're moving right along now. Anthony, some broken English for you. You ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Easy.
There isn't going to be any governess. You know it.
I know it too.
The Sound of Music.
Thank you.
What? Captain.
I can Von hear
Trapp.
It.
Von Trapp.
Christopher Plummer.
Your head must just be hollow because it's louder.
You've got it. Rock band is so loud, it's my ears are gone.
I'm as mad as hell, I'm not going to take any more.
Oh, and newsroom? No. Network?
Yes.
Shooter pinch. Shooter pinch.
Thank you very much. That's two down. Let's go shopping.
Let's go shopping.
Well, now let's finish the game first.
What?
We're going to move on. Then.
No, you're wrong. Guy Pearce and Priscilla, Queen of the Desert.
Oh, yes.
Stop you, Williams.
Well, hang on, hang on.
What we have here is a failure to communicate.
Sorry? Oh! What? What we have here is a failure to communicate. Strother Martin, Cool Hand Luke.
Yes, thank you very much. For many years, he's painted men and women who seem to be slaves of cocaine or a similar drug, which has reduced them to frenzied and shameless morbidity.
My psychiatrist? Sorry.
I have no idea. Don't look at me.
Hang on.
I'm going to give you 5 seconds. One, two, three, four, five. Bad luck!
Come on, you...
Sam Neill, Norman Lindsay and Sirens.
That's right. Sucked in.
Sirens. There, thank you.
We all knew that over here. We knew that.
I'm going to give you 6 points at the end of that. Go on.
Watched that film breast by breast, and that line was never.
I don't ever watch the swimming scene.
An Australian company has finally secured the rights to make an animated film version of Norman Lindsay's 80-year-old children's story, The Magic Pudding. There'll be a feature-length magic pudding and also a microwave magic pudding that tells the whole story in just under 3 minutes. The animated feature will have an unusual plot. 2 minutes in, Egbert Rumpus Bumpus notices the used-by date on the pudding is 1918 and it spends the rest of the movie on a compost heap. Producers say the budget is $12 million. Who's playing the bloody pudding? Demi Moore? And not to be outdone, Disney are rushing to complete their own dessert-based animated feature, Mickey Mouse. Stuff you all. Now, did you know the magic pudding wasn't Norman Lindsay's original idea for a children's character? No? But his friends thought the magic nymphomaniac with enormous breasts might have been a bit too scary for the under sevens. And the scores at this point in the game, we have the Robins team sitting pretty on 21 points. Right. Neck and neck with the McCrossan team on 21 points.
I choose to start the song now. Mr. Bumblebee, my petals are with pollen and they're heavy, don't you see? Mr. Bumblebee, Mr. Bumblebee. I'm tired, and I want to go to sleep. Bumblebee.
Big finishes take a long line, complete the next line of the song, 1 point for every correct answer. Peace, oh cake.
Okay.
Anthony, Zoe, Mikey.
Okay.
Your time begins now.
Okay, baby doll.
Two little boys had two little toys.
Each had a wooden horse.
Rolf Harris, what costume shall the poor girl wear?
I don't care.
We're timing.
I don't care, I'll do her.
We're going to move on to all tomorrow's parties. Velvet Underground and Nico. Oh, my baby is all right, she doesn't mind a bit of dirt.
Your gal is a...
real big flirt.
Yeah.
She says, horror vampire, bite, bite! Release the bats. The birthday party.
Oh, yeah.
Close your eyes.
Of course.
Okay, come on.
And I'll kiss you.
What?
Tomorrow I'll miss you.
Yes?
We know that one, thank you.
Remember, I'll...
Always be true.
And then while I'm away,
I'll run home every day.
And I'll send back
all my loving to you.
Next
one. All my loving, I will send to you.
Next one.
All my loving, darling, I'll be true.
Next one.
Okay, I'm in the phone booth. It's the one across the hall.
If you don't ring me, I'll rip off the wall.
Hang on, telephone. Blondie, summer breeze makes me feel fine.
Blows with the jasmine in my mind.
Seals and Croft, thank you very much. You take me by the heart?
When you take me by the hand. Oh, Mickey, can't you understand?
Mickey, Tony, Basil, giant steps, so what do you take?
The
police. Ricky, don't lose that number.
It's the only one that I've got.
Very close. You're going to call somebody else. Steely Dan, the history book on the shelf.
The history book on the shelf is not the one that I left there.
And here's the last one. Ladies and gentlemen, midnight, not a sound from the pavement.
Oh, the Oasis is crazy. Has midnight,
yes, come on. Midnight, not a sound from the pavement.
Has the moon lost its memory? Is it smiling alone?
Oh. Thank you. Very close. I'm going to give it to you.
Oh, thank you.
No, can we not have...
I'm sorry, Paul, can we not have that last point? Because I feel ashamed that anyone knew those lyrics.
I'm sorry, I'm a big fan of Rum Tum Tumpkin.
I'm going to take you back there. You haven't got it. Victorian police have launched an internal inquiry into claims by singer Deborah Byrne that cops copied and distributed a video of her and her ex-lover having sex.
Is this it?
I hear Margaret and David loved it. 5 stars. But it wasn't a homemade skin flick. It was Deborah's audition for the lead in Andrew Lloyd Webber's new musical, Beauty and the Beast with Two Backs. Sadly, Brian Harradine has now abandoned his moral crusade. He realizes his efforts are too little, too late, if one of the young talent team is making porno movies. One last word. If anyone who's watching tonight and they have a tape at home, the Victorian police want you to know that if you don't love it, you can swap it for free.
I can never figure it out. These people who, you know, videotape themselves and then watch it having, you know, having sex. The last person I want to see having sex is me.
You're the last person I want to see having sex as well, Mike.
I'm not going to be questioned.
Thank you very much. Okay, here we go.
All right.
Johnny is a guy who can't make up his mind.
Blah, blah, blah.
Since he likes it both ways.
Okay, you're not getting any extra points, but I'm going to give it to them. Supernaut. That goes in there. That goes in there.
This goes with that. Goes with this. Goes with that.
Almost. This is Hardcore by Pulp.
Well,
Candy Cane from Out on the Island.
In the back room, she was everybody's darling.
But she never lost her head.
Even when she was given head.
She said, hey, babe.
Take a walk on the wild side.
She said, hey, babe.
Take a walk on the wild side.
And the colored girls go.
Hey, that's funky dancing, Julie.
Went down to Santa Fe.
Where Renoir paints the wall.
Hang on, where Renoir paints the wall.
And we're ever going to see your face again. Because tonight, for the first time, just about 10:30.
Oh, I know this one. Something about the bananas in pajamas.
Come on. Come on. For the first time in history.
It's about 10:30. The rain came down.
It's going to start raining.
It's going to start raining men.
It's going to start raining men.
The weather girls. Pretty women out walking.
Down Marsh Street.
Pretty women out walking.
Down Marsh Street.
Pretty women out walking.
Oh, Paul, with gorillas down Marsh
Street. Thank you very much. Is she really going out with him, Joe Jackson?
Forgot the gorillas.
Off the coast, I'm headed nowhere.
Yeah, that'd be right.
She's a brick and I'm slowly drowning. And the last one, got myself a smiling, walking, breathing, talking.
Living doll.
Living doll. Thank you very much. Go wild for them, ladies and gentlemen.
Idea.
Cliff Richard, one of the headline acts at this week's Princess Diana tribute, says he would have killed to sing at her funeral. Isn't that incredible? If Cliff owns a white Fiat Uno, I think we're onto something. But it's a really horrible thing to say until you realise the person he would have had to kill is Elton John. And Cliff would have gone through with it too, but the only blunt instrument he could find on the day was Christa Berg.
What is up with Christa Berg's eyebrows? It's like two caterpillars have died on his forehead.
The ageless singer even had to... His performance all worked out for the big night. He was going to sing Wired for Sound while his dancers reenacted the tunnel crash on roller skates.
I like big speakers.
Thank you very much. very much. Mikey Robbins, Zoe Carides, and Anthony Morgan scored 32 points. Just inching in front of Julie McCross and Fiona Horn and Peter Berner on 30 points. Sorry. Before we go, a quick weekend news flash.
I am in hell!
We can't all be winners, only they can be winners! A quick news flash. Jar Jar Gabor has just announced that she will make a video for her new single in Australia. I want you all to join with me in heartfelt prayer that it won't be a Deborah Byrne-style video. Good night.
Of your hand.